From San Francisco, California, this is the Rock and Roll Geek Show.
This is the story of my rock and roll butler.
Welcome to the Rock and Roll Geek Show. My name is Michael Butler. Thanks a lot for joining me. I really appreciate it. Today is Wednesday, August 3rd, 2022, and it is 6 o'clock. It's actually 5:58 p.m. when I'm recording this episode. I'm opening up my second Tecate of the day. Always the best, as they say. I have been working my ass off, as Phil Hendry says. Today's day three of the dog days of podcasting, where me and probably like 14 or 15 other podcast nerds attempt to do a show a day for the entire month of August. So this is the third day. We're just getting started. I got no audio comments, so that either says that nobody listens to the show and nobody's taking me up on my begging for audio comments and show reviews. Means either nobody listens to the show anymore, the show's dead, nobody likes the dog days of podcasting, or I don't know. It's only three I can think of. All right. Well, I don't really have much to talk about today, so we're going to do a little bit of opening Butler's Mail. So I'm going to the other side of my little closet-sized studio/office here, and I'm going to grab this box that came in the mail yesterday. All right. It's in a priority mailbox. It says it's from Scott F. Davis from, I won't give the address, but it's in Westford, MA. What is MA? Massachusetts? Westford, Massachusetts. All right, I'm opening it up here. Priority mailbox, all right. It looks like a book of some sort. All right, let's get the knife out and we'll tear this bubble wrap apart. I know this is very interesting for a podcast audience, but what are you going to do, friends? All right, it says picture. It's Michael, enjoy the book. Hope to talk soon. Signed, SLR. All right. Who's SLR? I don't know who SLR is, but let's open up this book. All right. It's hermetically sealed here. All right. I hope I don't cut myself. Oh, I just cut myself. Holy motherfucking shit. You got to be kidding me. I just poked my stomach with the knife. That's wonderful. All right. Got it open here. Am I bleeding? No, it's not bleeding. Thank God. All right. It's a paperback book, but it's a nice big coffee table size paperback book. It's called Pictures Alive. Let me pull the microphone up to myself. Pictures Alive, Rock Shows of the 80s and Beyond by Steve Roney and Scott Davis. Okay, Steve Roney is actually a friend of mine. Well, he's a fellow musician in the Bay Area. He's in a bunch of bands. One of the bands he's in is called Cheaper Trick. They're a Cheap Trick cover band. And I actually played one rehearsal with them and told them that I couldn't do it because I was just in too many bands. And it was a long way to travel for rehearsal. But it's all pictures in some words. Wow, it's a good-looking book. I think he self-published this. This is on, self-published. Pictures Alive, Rock Shows of the 80s and Beyond by Steve Roney and Scott Davis. There are a bunch of backstage passes here. Blackfoot and Def Leppard. Blackfoot headlining, Def Leppard opening. Dio with Dokken opening November 3rd, Oakland Coliseum. Most of these are Bay Area shows because he's a Bay Area guy. AC/DC in Nantucket. I was at that show, actually. I went to the one in Jacksonville Coliseum. This is from the Cow Palace. Saxon Accept, Kiss and Wasp. I might have seen the Jacksonville version of that show. Foreigner, Loverboy, Scorpions, Iron Maiden, the special guest, Twisted Sister. Ted Nugent with the Michael Schenker Group. All right, that's the first page only. This book is going to take me a long time to get through. These are all like flyers from the shows. And then there's a whole bunch of ticket stubs. Oh, it comes with a little bookmark that's got the ticket stubs on it. And Scott, by the way, Scott Roney is also a paint contractor too, I think. It's a good looking book. Pictures from 90. Okay, he's got a bunch of pictures. Van Halen. Oh, so he's got ticket stubs, and then he talks about some of the ticket stubs. Like, for instance, Van Halen, The Fools, June 13th, 1981, Oakland Coliseum, and he talks about when he went to the show. Imagine this, Van Halen's coming to the Oakland Coliseum for 3 sold-out shows. My friend Chipper tells his buddy Rob Scarlett, 4 second-row center seats, and he will let me have his last ticket for $20, which I was more than happy to pay. All right, so he tells stories of these shows he went to, Ozzy and Motorhead, and there's pictures he took, and they're good pictures, too. Y&T in San Francisco. There's a picture of Kirk Hammett. That's Menichetti looking like Kirk Hammett. Bunch of pictures. Gamma featuring Ronnie Montrose. All right, good-looking book. Thank you for sending me that, Scott Roney. I may have him on the show to talk about this. Wow, there's Def Leppard and Blackfoot. Def Leppard's opening for Blackfoot, I'm pretty sure. And this is with Pete Willis in the band, and back when Joe Elliott had dark hair. Really good photos. How he snuck a camera into these shows, I don't know. Maybe I'll ask him that. Ozzy Osbourne with special guest Starfighters featuring, Starfighters is Angus and Malcolm's cousins, Stevie, I think, right? Is that a Stevie Wright? Good pictures of Randy Rhoads. Good pictures of, AC/DC and Midnight Flyer. Well, I'm gonna have to dig into this book here. I just flipped it here, and there's a picture of UFO with Pete Way playing a Washburn bass, which I have that bass, except he's playing a black one with Paul Chapman on guitar and who's the keyboard player also playing a Washburn. It looks like the whole band is endorsed by Washburn. Was it? Who's the other guitar player? Who's the guy from, I don't remember the guy's name. Not Paul Raymond, not the guy who blew me off, who's playing with him now, but a different guy. Parnell, is it Denny Parnell? Denny Pier? I don't know. They should take away the Rock and Roll Geek cred card, because I don't remember the guy's name. There's Iron Maiden Down the Green 2. Really good photos. And what I like about this is there's stories about these shows that he goes to. So I can't wait to dig into this. It's called Pictures Alive, Rock Shows of the 80s and Beyond by Steve Roney and Scott Davis. I'm going to take a picture of this, and I will post it on the show notes at rockandrollgeek.com on this episode. Thank you again, Steve Roney, for that. This is going to be a quick read, and it's really good picture. Wow, this picture of Steve Harris from 1982, looking like a kid wearing spandex pants. And Bruce Dickinson looking like a kid as well. Good pictures. Really good. How did he sneak a camera into these shows? Maybe that's in this book somewhere. I'll ask him. Thank you again. All right, that's going to do it. I've been playing covers, which started off as a post from Tim Shaw on the Rock and Roll Geek Facebook group, possible greatest cover ever by an Iron Maiden doing a Jethro Tull cover. Well, I'm going from the most recent down, and I came across this one, which is Adrian Bashan posted this. This is Damone doing an Iron Maiden cover. And this is one of my favorite covers. Damone, if you do not know Damone, get those first two albums. They're really good. The singer, Noelle LeBlanc, not only is she super cute, but she also has the voice of an angel. And this is a great cover. They took Wasted Years and made it into a ballad. And I love it. Thank you for listening, friends. As I always say, it's a value for value, so if you get any value out of this, put a number on it, and please send it to me, friends. rockandrollgeek@gmail.com is my email. rockandrollgeek.com is the website. There's a Rock and Roll Geek Facebook group as well. You can find me on the Facebook, R&R Geek. Find me on the Twitter, R&R Geek. Find me on the Instagram, rockandrollgeek. Don't ask. Let me take another sip of this fine Tecate, second one of the day. Second sip of the second one of the day. That is the best one. Ah, I just made peach ice cream with the $1,000 ice cream maker. Man, did it come out good. This weekend, I'm going to Santa Rosa to my brother-in-law. His company does this yearly theme company parties on their farm in Santa Rosa. And I have been asked to roast a pig, a whole pig, and I've never done it before. I'm going to attempt to do it. I will probably have the microphone and maybe talk about that, bring the backpack app on my phone. I'm going to be roasting it with something called a La Caja China, which is a roasting box. So I've never used one. I've seen it done, and I've watched YouTube videos. I will post pictures and stuff. I'm looking forward to doing that. I hope I don't fuck it up because it's the main food for this party. It's a Hawaiian-themed party. So he asked me to roast the pig underground, which I don't know if I'm I don't know if I'm confident enough to do that. I would hate to undercook the pig. But the La Caja China roasting box seems like it's doable for someone like me. If you know any good whole pig marinades, let me know, rockandrollgeek@gmail.com. All right, friends, that's going to do it for me. Here's Damone doing an Iron Maiden cover, Wasted Years. I will talk to you soon, friends. Oh, wait a second. The professionalism is just off the charts, friends. Here's Damone doing Iron Maiden, Wasted Years. I'll talk to you tomorrow with day 4 of the Dog Days of Podcasting. Thank you for listening, friends.
From the coast of gold, across the seven seas, I'm traveling on far and wide. But now it seems I'm just a stranger to myself, and all these things I sometimes do, it isn't me but someone else. I close my eyes and think of home. Another city goes by. Until it's gone away, and my heart's lying there, and will be till my dying day. So understand, don't waste your time always searching for those wasted years. Too much time on my hands, got you on my mind.
It's a rock and roll geek train wreck.